Hi, it's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.net, and we're in the little garden, and we're harvesting peppers and tomatoes and squash. So I've been waiting now to harvest these Hungarian wax peppers. One of them is now red, which means it's fully ripe. And I'm going to take the yellow one also. And I'm going to take these two large yellow ones. I'll leave that other little yellow one. Then we have an eggplant, which I may let get just a little bit bigger. And let me see, do I have any other greens? Oh yeah, there's a huge green one back here. Look at that beauty. And while I'm right here, I'm going to harvest this Russian persimmon tomato. It's a yellow tomato. Got a little bruise there, but that's okay. We will take that part out. And I'm guessing as long as they're this bright orangey yellow. Now see, here's another one that's not good. And I'm blaming this all on the weather. This, I believe, is blossom end rot. And it's caused by either too little calcium, which I highly doubt because I've been putting on my powdered milk, or it's caused by fluctuations in moisture, which we definitely have had this summer. So this one I will destroy. Is that another one back here? No, I'll leave that one. And I think over on the other side we may find a couple more. Now these are fern tomatoes. They have this feathery kind of leaf. It was really a neat plant when it first started. They tend to have smaller tomatoes, but abundant. So I think these would be some that I would recommend for next year because they're lovely fruit. And these are the stupas tomato from Czechoslovakia. They seem to remain small. They do tend to crack along the top. So, I don't know. They're very tasty, but I don't like that crack in there.
Think part of it might be the weather?
It could be.
Because this is an unusually warm, long warm spell.
With very little water.
I shouldn't even use the word warm.
No, it's definitely hot. And although it's very humid, we really haven't had much rain, and thus, good thing, no mosquitoes. Well, few mosquitoes. Now, somebody's been enjoying this tomato, so I will also destroy that one. Beans, pretty much, they've gone to blossom again, so we'll get another crop in maybe a week or two. Peas are gone. I've pretty much started pulling those out. Now let's look over here and see if we have any of our favorite squash, the delicata zeppelin. Okay, and here's one right here. See, these are great for packer land because they are the packer colors. They're kind of creamy and green.
And what did your son and your husband have to say about those delicata zeppelins?
Absolutely. They took one bite and they were in love with them. They are so sweet and the texture is buttery. So I'm almost forbidden to even give any away so other people can taste them. Let me see, are there any more? If I could even get there. Now I'm ready to harvest these tomatoes on this side. As you might remember from a previous video, I'm doing a comparison between worm castings and alpaca compost. Here the two plants are side by side. Both of them are loaded with plants, fruit. The worm casting one, again, it's got the blossom end rot from this temperature. And this one, too, has a little blemish, but about the same size, maybe a little bit bigger for the alpaca one so far. I guess that's it. I guess I'm caught up. Bye for now. Got to get out of this heat. So today is August 7th, and this is what we've picked just today. From the spaghetti squash to the zeppelin squash, a patty pan, cucumbers, Hungarian wax peppers, tomatoes, one green pepper, and a couple of pickles. Not bad for one day. Thanks, God. Bye.